What's up, guys? Jen here from Serenity Hill. I am finally sitting down and getting my garden all planned out. This is actually going to be a really exciting year because I not only am planning here at our backyard homestead, and it is looking more like we're probably going to be here at least one more year. That update is coming in another video, but I have quite the plan for this homestead here that I will go through with you in a minute, but I am also going to be starting the garden out on the farm, which is super exciting. I have done a little bit here and there, and you know, I've done like a pumpkin patch. Well, I tried to do a pumpkin patch, done some herbs, I've done some sunflowers, we started fruit trees, things like that. We mostly are just kind of harvesting from what is growing wild out there. But this year I'm going all out. I'm gonna finally get the garden started. We're getting everything else cleared that needs to be cleared and cut down and mulched. So we'll have some beautiful mulch to go over that ground. So we'll have two huge gardens to work on, which is so exciting. And a tad probably too much. I'm really good at overwhelming myself. So we're just gonna be consistent with that this year. Okay, so here is the plan for the backyard homestead. All right, if you notice here, there are no tomatoes and some other things that I usually grow in here in the main garden are not in here. I'm gonna put all that out on the farm. So this year, I'm gonna put our beans and our peas. I'm gonna kind of curve a cattle panel a little bit here and a little bit here. Last year, this pretty much rusted. I kind of just left whatever was gonna grow in there grow, and I did okra a line right here. But this is gonna be the peas and the beans. I got holy basil here, oregano. I found that having a nice walkway over here is good, so I know it's a big empty space, but it's gonna work well. But knowing me, honestly, I'll find things at the greenhouse and this will be my add to the garden with random plants spot. And it'll still be crowded to walk around because that's what I do. So we'll just leave that open for that. Bell peppers and jalapenos. We eat a ridiculous amount of bell peppers. So I'm going to plant a ridiculous amount of bell peppers. So this is, I do plant them about a foot apart, and this year I'm gonna stake them. I've never really staked them before, but last year I had some that were flopping over, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do it. So we've got quite a few bell peppers, and then a couple rows of jalapenos. I've got a couple varieties of jalapenos I'm excited to try too. I usually just do my standard green jalapenos, but I've got some other ones that are gonna be exciting. I'm gonna do a couple ground cherry plants because we love those things. Me and my daughter just go in there and eat them like candy. They're so good, so, so good. I am determined this year to get decent cabbage and cauliflower, and this is going to be dill right here, and I've got broccoli rabe here. So we'll see how this does. I'm gonna get some row covers for this stuff just because cabbage loopers, you know, we don't usually get them too bad, but we do get them, and I really don't want to. I'm gonna put a lot of focus into this year, and I really don't want them to get decimated. So we're gonna get some covers and prevent that problem before it starts. This is kale. So we're gonna do a few plants of those, and then this is gonna be a mix. It's gonna be like our lettuce patch. We've got endive, lettuce, a couple different lettuces, and spinach is all gonna be right in here where the green beans were last year. This little thing on the side, I'm making like my little mini at-home perennial garden. This is chamomile, that comes up every year. Sorrel, what does that say? Mullein, I'm gonna put there. That does grow and spread, so we'll see how that works. Sage, rosemary, and more sage. These were there from last year. We'll see if they survived. They're pretty good and covered by massive amounts of snow, so we'll see. We'll see how they do. If not, I'll replant them. As I was drawing this out, I started thinking about my goals, and that's really, I think for new gardeners, and that's why I really wanted to do this video now and not wait until later, because a lot of people are starting to plant their seeds or start their seeds inside. Especially for our area, we're starting to get the ish. We're in like 5A flirting with 4B up here in Illinois. And there's a lot of people that are starting to ask me questions about when to start seeds and just locally and what to plant and how to do things. And because there's so many new gardeners, I just figured I would write this down for myself and just to walk through with you guys. So if you are a new gardener starting out, this might help you a little bit. So I started with what our goals were gonna be. Based off of what I did last year and what I still have in our canning pantry, I want to pressure can 60 quarts of green beans, for this year, 50 quarts of salsa, 40 quarts of pasta sauce, 20 quarts of chili base, and that's just how I process all my tomatoes, 50 pints of cowboy candy. We love this stuff. It's really good on cream cheese, on a cracker, just with a piece or two on top of it. It's so good, especially in the winter when it's really cold and you have something really spicy. Oh, it's so good. But it's also really good as a marinade too if you like spicy dishes. And 20 pints of pepper jelly and 50 quarts of bell peppers. This is like quart bags we're gonna do because I freeze these. So that is my goal. Now I will do more than this. I'll do some other things, but this is kind of like my staples. This is what I want to make sure I have. I'll also have potatoes. Last year I learned a lot growing potatoes for the first time. I'll link a video if you want to see that harvest and what we learned from that. That was a really good experience, and you can see down here we'll be doing it again. And I'll probably add some over here. I've got a big empty space. Maybe I'll get some more. I'll build some more of these or get some potato bags. Maybe do some here. There's space. We'll do it. We'll figure it out. We'll cram it all in. Anyway, so that is my preservation goals. My dehydrating goals. Well, I say preservation. Those are my canning goals. Dehydrating. Basically all of the herbs that I grow, I want to dehydrate. Some of them I use for teas. Some of them I use down here, you can see, for salves. Some of them I use like to infuse with oils, and you can use those fresh. Some of them you can dehydrate and use. And then this is the container garden. This is the container garden area I have here. This here, mullein, I've got planted in here, is gonna be like in a trough. I wanna get a big barrel and elevate that for the chives. And then these are just containers that I've got laying around. I've got more than four, I think. And if I do, then I'll fit more in there. That is a bigger space than what I drew. But that's what I've got planted. I've got mint that's already in those pots, and I overwintered them. They're rooted in the ground, so we'll see where they pop up. This is thyme and marjoram. This is my 4x4 cucumber bed, and I'm gonna put some yarrow there. This is the 4x8 raised bed that we have that is currently, it's got some framing around it because we were going to make it something else, but I'm gonna take it down and I'm going to use the windows and kind of reframe it differently so that I can hinge it down and it will be a different setup for cold frame. So that'll be handy to have for next winter too, so I don't have to fight with snow so much. Over here, this is our hugelkultur bed area. I'm gonna plant some perennial stuff and then some annual stuff, but I'm gonna do sorrel, I'm gonna do lemon balm, some different kinds of basil that I have. You see, remember, I have the holy basil up here. I've got some different kinds of basils. I've got like three or four different kinds. I love basil. We're gonna do that there. Evie, can you please turn the sound off with that since I'm trying to film? Thank you, ma'am. Calendula, I use calendula for salves, for oil infusion. I use it in my soap that I make. It's great stuff and it's gorgeous. It's just so pretty. So I'm gonna do a bunch of calendula there, and then I'm gonna do some mixed flowers here. I've got probably coneflower, echinacea. I've got zinnias, I've got more calendula, different kinds. So that's what I've got there. So that is going to be the garden, the space for our backyard homestead. This year we are adding bees. It is a done deal. I have the hives, they are ready to go, or they're finishing getting ready, a few of them. We've got to do a couple more things, but the bees are ordered. We are getting Italians. I'm very excited. I got them from a local place, pretty local. They're about an hour and a half away from me, but I'm very, very excited about it. We're finally gonna have bees. I am still gonna set swarm traps because, ooh, let's focus. I do have several hive setups that I have from friends, and you know what? I might as well give it a shot. Even if I completely and totally fail, I'm still learning a lot. I know I did last year setting swarm traps and setting things up, so we'll see how it goes. But this is the bee garden. I'm gonna fence this. It's gonna be 20 foot by 20 foot. These are going to be, let's see, I'm gonna do two by eight garden beds, two by six garden beds, and then these are gonna be the raised beds that Wyatt actually made that we had them out last year. I'm just gonna move them over here and leave a path open to walk. So that's what I'm gonna do. And these are gonna be, this is just the bee garden. This is going to be a lot of different herbs, a lot of nice flowering things, different things that bloom at different times. So that if they've got a nice area here, they're gonna go everywhere. They're gonna go all over the place. But this is just a nice little area where you know, things are kind of immediately accessible. And honestly, I mean, I'm gonna be as honest as I can be with this here. It is naive to think that your bees are not going to go anywhere. That's what they do. They fly miles and miles to pollinate, to get what they need, to turn into food for themselves. Our land, though, is 10 acres of just raw land, and so much blooms there. So I'm really hoping within our 10 acres and the 26 acres next to us and the forest around us and all the wild stuff that runs and the creek that goes into the next property, and all this stuff that I'm planting here within our garden and within our bee garden and just everything that grows native, that they don't wander out into the fields that get sprayed. That might be a little naive, but you know what? All I can do is try, right? So those fields are pretty far away from us. So the more that I plant here for them, the closer they can stay. I'm sure it's not gonna be, this is not nearly enough, but hopefully this is a good step in the right direction. And everything that I do, year after year just kind of helps them, provides more food for them. So that's the bee garden. This is exciting too. You can see my goals: keep the bees alive and get everything established. And then we'll just build on it every year, as you do when you garden. So something I'm really excited about doing is making perennial gardens. Last year we started a couple, actually they're about here, these two pear trees. And then this year we're gonna do more apple trees and a cherry tree. This big section here, it's actually more like this. It's huge. That's gonna be our annual pumpkin patch. I've got, if you haven't seen my seed haul yet, I'll link up here for you guys to see that. I've got several varieties of pumpkins I'm excited to plant. In here, I've already got these done. We transplanted our golden thornless raspberries that I had here at the backyard homestead, and I separated them all out and it made several plants. So we've got those there. This year, I'm gonna put some blackberries in. Next to that, this is the South Perennial Garden. We've got some high bush blueberries. I've got six plants started already. I'm gonna add to them and add another row if I can find them all. Finding the right high bush varieties here was proved challenging over the last few years. So I did find a good place to get them last year. So hopefully they carry them this year and I can get them there. We're gonna build some 4x30 perennial herb beds. These are going to be pretty much all the herbs that I've talked about. They're also going to go in the bee garden. They're also going to go here. I want to grow tons of medicinal herbs this year. This, in addition to what grows wild on this property here, we'll have so many different herbs and I'm really excited to use them. And then this area here is going to be a big bush kind of area. There's a couple different kinds of fruits that I want to grow here, a couple different kinds of berries, but I'm not 100% sure which one I'm going to go with yet. I'll keep you posted. I don't know if this is gonna happen this year, but we'll see what happens. But this is gonna be the space for it. That's what I've planned anyway. That could change. So this is, okay, so this is the way this works. I'll show you. That is pretty much gonna go like that. And then this goes, let's back this up. And then this goes over here. So this is the way this is all laid out. There is quite a big space in between this and this. I don't know, I have to watch this area. We have a lot of hills here, hence the name Serenity Hill. We have, I know watching this is the area that the chickens were in last year, and they're parked right about here. This year, this is gonna be like, this is where corn and tomatoes are gonna be, right here, in this big area here. But this area, I spent the year watching the way the water runs down the hill, and it kinda does this kind of thing. Here, right about in here, there's quite a little divot. It's like this gully that everything just kind of runs to. So we're gonna have to work with that. I believe in working with the land, not against it. I think that might temporarily solve your problem, but sooner or later, it's gonna win, especially when you get this kind of storms that we get here. So we're gonna do something. I'm gonna have to do something, but I wanna watch it because right now this is all still wooded and we're gonna clear all this out in March and I'm just gonna have to watch it and figure. I know this is gonna be good, but this area right here is where I'm concerned. So we're just gonna have to watch and see, and we'll probably do something with this next year. So that is the whole plan as of now. Things are always, I always come up with a plan, and I always think it's good to write out your plan, but know that this is not concrete. This is a lot. This is a lot even for a really seasoned gardener. I mean, starting and keeping an established garden is one thing, but three pages of brand new plus what you normally do, it's a lot. And those properties are 10 miles apart. So it is going to be quite the commitment, but we're up for it and we're excited about it. Me especially. I'm super excited about it. Somewhere in there, I will have chickens. I'm going to set up the chicken tractor so it's just moving in between rows. If you are a new gardener and you are doing your garden for the first time, let me know in the comments how it is going. If you've started your planning, if you are kind of overwhelmed with the planning process. I will be starting my seeds soon, so watch out for that video coming. And I'll walk through how I set them up. Everybody does it a little bit differently, but I'll walk through my setup and the soil I use and how I mix things and how I get everything ready to get my seeds going. So I hope you guys are having a good day and we'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.